Experiment 32 deals with the vitamin C content of foods. Let's have a look at the data and report pages. The Prelab review begins with a number of questions, and the very first one, specific safety alerts. You'll want to look for the triangle icons. Number two, disposal directions. You'll look for the garbage can icons. And the rest of these questions are based upon the content and the reading. Not too difficult. Number nine, what substances are weighed accurately in this experiment? Well, in part D, you read that it's the raw cabbage. And here are the data and report sheets now. Part A deals with the standardization of the oxidizing agent, the NBS. The very first bit of data that you'll enter, the concentration of standard vitamin C in milligrams per milliliter. And that's 0.50. I'll give you that number. It's in your reading, but it's a rather critical number. And the second critical number, the volume of standard vitamin C solution titrated all the way through the experiment. You use a pipette, a 10 milliliter pipette, and the pipette is accurate to the hundredth. So you'd want to record 10.00. And once in a while, students record 15 milliliters for this blank. That's the amount of liquid that you begin with, but it's not the amount that you measure out. And then we have the initial burette reading and final burette reading. Whenever you use a burette, you can record its readings to the hundredth. So make sure that you do that. Over here in table 32.2 is the report part now. The first couple of blanks I don't think will present any problem for you. Number of milligrams of vitamin C in titrated sample. Well, you'd multiply the volume times the concentration, keep track of the units, and that would give you milligrams. The volume of NBS used in the titration, well, that'll come from your burette readings. And then this third bit of data, I've labeled A, because we want to use that value in subsequent parts of the experiment. It should be recorded to two significant figures. In part B, where you're analyzing an unknown, again, the volume of unknown titrated, 10.00 milliliters. Burette readings, you'll want to record to the hundredth. Over here in the table 32.4, the unknown ID number, remember that you get that when you log into ChemWeb. It's a four-digit number that's specific for you, and enter it there. The volume of NBS required in the titration, well, you'll get that by the difference in these two burette readings. I've labeled it B. The number of milligrams of vitamin C in the titrated sample, I've labeled C, and it won't be hard for you to calculate those two values, but I've labeled them so that I can give you a little equation here for calculating that value of C. It's equal to B divided by the A that we had in our first bit of data. And again, it should be expressed to two significant figures. So this little calculation is one that you'll do now all the way through the experiment using that value of A. Part C deals with the vitamin C content of orange juice. Volume titrated, you know what that'll be. You'll have initial and final burette readings. You'll use that data then in the report for table 32.6. The volume of NBS required, well, that'll be the difference in the burette readings. And you'll divide that volume by A to get this number here. So that'll help you a lot. You use A. A is really pretty critical. You use it all the way through the experiment. In part D, you look at the vitamin C content of cabbage, a solid, and you'll have some masses, initial and final burette readings, and then in the report again, you'll use that value of A to calculate the milligrams of vitamin C in the sample. Here we are now at the questions at the end. Again, these are based upon the experiment. I don't think you'll have trouble with them, but I'll give you a little tip on number three. The correct answer is C, and I'd like you to explain to me why the correct answer is C. And there we are, five post-lab questions. I hope you have fun with the experiment. Remember to give me a call or email if I can be of help.